collaborating with government, with NEMA or with...
Door closing. 11th floor.
Environmental sustainability goal. Hi guys, and welcome back to our YouTube channel. Thank you so much for clicking this video. So in today's video, we are going for an event that we have been invited. It's an environmental sustainability goals event. Yes, ESG. So last time we were also invited to that event, and it was so nice. It deals with environmental and climate conservation. It also deals with the protection of the ozone layer. Yeah. So it's such an educational event, and today I am just going alone. Baby's not around. Yeah, so I decided to take you guys along so that we can get wisdom and knowledge together, guys. Yeah, so stay tuned to this video and watch it till the end. You can learn something that can be important to you, because this ESG plan, it involves everyone, guys, everyone. Taking care of the environment involves all of us. It is not only for some people, because we all live in this earth and we have to take good care of this earth, or else El Nino itakuja. Oh, that's a joke. Even if it is not El Nino, the world can lack something kama maji. Yes, and I've read some articles. They are saying that the environment imechafuliwa, the world maji inapungua, some areas even don't have water, there is no rain because of this daily and lifestyle activities that we are doing. So this particular event is all about to educate young people and even older people on how to take good care of the environment, to avoid these pollutants, to avoid those harmful substances that they are being drained into the water, to take good care of the aquatic lives. Yeah. So that's how I decided to take you guys through. It's such a good event. Please stay tuned and you're going to enjoy. So let's go. But before I go, let me show you the outfit of the day. My hair, guys. That's my hair. And then I have this kablaza here. Yes. And then this sleeveless top that I have matched it with this black pant. And then I have these shoes, beautiful one, guys, as you can see. So this is the outfit of the day. Okay, yeah, so let's go, guys, and we're going to enjoy together. Hi guys, leo mimi nimeshuka, and now I am heading to the hotel where the meeting will be held. It's in Westlands Heights.
Hey guys,
Western Heights. But in Kifika, Nita Yora too. Chani, we leave the Kwanza. Yes, guys, I am in this. This area is so cool. Let me show you the backside. Guys, the views is viewing. I arrived at Western Heights and that's me. I am heading to take the lift to go to the 11th floor where the meeting will be held.
He's not going to make
doors opening. Going up. Door closing.
Finally, guys, I arrived at the meeting. I get the meeting was already started. I was a bit late, but not that much late. And this was the session which was going on about the EPR regulations.
Subject to this legislation. When we talk about the five waste streams, I think they're actually now, the language has changed. They're called waste clusters. And it includes everything from like construction, waste. I think a lot of people here are from the real estate sector. So imagine if you're building something and at the end of the life of that building there's demolition, that waste cannot be just allowed to just float around.
These yellow tags were given at the door before we entering the room. This is a sign that you are there by invite. Yes, you are not just crashing the event.
Very solid governance system. Everybody in the value chain of that material is having a seat on the board. Each material is represented by what we call an EPR council. That council decides what should be the EPR fee to collect from the waste, from the packaging users, and how much of that should be given as a subsidy to the waste collectors, sorters, and recyclers in order to move capital from the polluters to the waste service providers, with the intention that every year the recycling rate should keep increasing. And eventually over a few years, we want to move from just doing recycling to full circularity, which I'll explain in a moment.
Called Africa Climate Change Action Foundation, and the name in itself says a lot. It's Africa because we are talking about African solutions to African problems. The word action there is vital because we want to take action. Through the four founder members, we have found ourselves in situations in our previous life that a lot is being said, a lot is being discussed in boardroom talks, in conferences such as this. There's so much good information there. I'm so impressed by all the speakers. I feel they have actually articulated so much of what I wanted to say. So the awareness is there, but where's the action? That is what we're looking to do. Again, we put it up as a foundation. Why? Despite our given backgrounds in the NGO sectors and most of us, we don't want this to be a charity case. We don't want handouts in Africa. We don't want charity work. We want to have opportunities, innovations, and we are very much capable of solving our own problems. So that's how we came up with our name. And today I'm speaking on something that has become my life's work, my passion, which is climate change, and basically conserving this environment. ACAF is set up as a strategic investment fund, which is promoting sustainable, green and innovative business throughout sub-Saharan Africa. So that is very intentional again, because we're looking at revenue positive projects. All our projects are revenue positive, as I said, because that will be the only way we will be able to have sustainability. When you have these climate smart projects that we do, and you do not have sustainability in them, then you have a longevity or a lifespan of a few months or a year. A lot of these schools don't have an active feeding program. So food security, but not just food security, how are they going to be sustainable? So you have our grow houses in there, your greenhouses and your vertical farms, we also help them achieve that. We also have our off-grid systems, where you use things like biodigesters so that they can be sustainable in their own fuel. These biodigesters, they can go to their communities and source for waste food product, feed them into the biodigester, and this helps power their schools, provides them even with hot water for taking a shower, and so on and so forth. We also provide them with, so we go out there with our educational curriculums that speak to climate change, which are adapted for the different age groups from your very basic levels up to institutional levels. And you educate them on the measures that they need to take to mitigate, to adapt to these climate change issues. And that's our grassroots initiative. And our grassroots initiative, we source for local partners who want to actively participate in solving this problem. Because once again, collectivity and working together is going to help us achieve this. So that's the long and short of who ACAF are.
My name is Peter Wairegi, and I've stated earlier, I'm from KPRA. I am the chairman and executive director there. I'm also the MD for Global Link East Africa. So I think I'll hope to do three things. One is to mention why KPRA is relevant to you. Secondly, as my responsibility for our host, is talk just briefly about ESG with main focus on environment. And last is, what's in it for you, the action way forward. So we start a little bit with the KPRA. KPRA is a professional body. It was started in 2012. I'm glad Michael Alden is here, because
talk, I think, at some point in time. But I think, from my understanding, a lot of people below that superpower level think that this whole ESG thing is for those big boys out there. And I just have so much to worry about day to day that please don't allow that to interfere with my life and my survival. But I think it's very interesting that what we've been hearing this morning is that this is not just for the big boys anymore. It doesn't need to be, and it isn't. And collaborating with government, with NEMA or with whoever. And so that's good. They are promoting the private sector corporate social responsibility, but what are the CSR projects within government?
So guys, if I went to these high-end hotels, I have to see their washrooms, and oh my god, this one was a top-notch, 4/5, yeah.
relaxation or taking.
So when I came back, I found out that people were doing yoga and relaxation and I joined in. Okay. I can't be left outside. We have to relax our shoulder, our heads, our mind. Yeah, that's me there practicing what we were being told to do.
Back up, forward, down and round, and once more. Inhale, shoulders forward, exhale, round and down. Now for the backward shoulder rotation, inhale, bring your shoulders to front, up, round, back and down. Cycle, inhale.
So after the yoga session, we went for a tea break and people were very, very much hungry. So we enjoy our tea break and the views and the sceneries. And then we went back for the afternoon sessions.
This beautiful girl here is called Virginia. She's my namesake. Hi, Virginia, if you're watching this.
So guys, when you are at the Western Heights rooftop, you will be able to see Westgate Mall, the Sarit Center Mall, and then there is also another hotel this side. I don't know its name, but I mean this area, there is a lot of good hotels. The scenery, the views and the ambience, everything is nice. So that's me enjoying it after taking my breakfast. So guys, immediately after enjoying the view, we went back for the afternoon session. Unfortunately, my phone went off. I have to charge it for a couple hours. And then the moment it was almost half percentage, it was time now to leave. And that's me on the lift. We are leaving. The event was over. But before leaving the hotel, we have to take some pictures. Content creators, you get me? Yeah, so let me put for you some good pictures that we took there. So after taking the photos, we were now leaving the hotel and I got a friend who is called Hilda. Hi Hilda, if you are watching this. She's the one who took me photos and also I also took her photos and then we were making some stories while we were walking towards the road and then we decided because it's too early for us to going back home, let's enter Sarit Center. We just take some rounds there and we see the views and then we go home. And this was my first time in Sarit Center. I've never been into Sarit Center before, guys. So yeah, I agreed. I wanted to see the Sarit Center. Here we are. Guys, Sarit Center ni kupoa. Tunaenda na escalator.
Tunaenda. Hapo mimi kuja hapa lakini naenda specific
places.
Guys, this is my first time in Sarit Center, guys. Huko wanakuanga kama na yani kila kitu tuseme, si ndio? Wow. Hai ni suku. Wengine wanaendeshwa na gari. Hivi.
Tusiende specific place kinda.
Tukiangalia.
So unachukua.
Mimi nachukua ngatu naweka hivi nitaweka YouTube nisema this was my first time in Sarit Center. Ndasema nilikuwa na wewe nitakuta.
Nitakusema.
Unaitwa?
Hilda.
Hilda. Nina rafiki yangu anaitwa Hilda pia. Mimi naitwa Virginia.
Virginia.
Tuendele hivi. Yeah. Today nimepata na peshte moja. Sema hi.
Hi.
Tumeamua kuingia huko Sarit Center kuzunguka. So how are you? And this is my first time in Sarit Center. I've never been here. Acha nionyeshe mitaa.
Niko straight kwa juu.
Hey, I'm in love with this area, wallahi. Ni poa. Huko hadi ni kwa mtu na babe wake. Kai nitaambia babe wangu pia nilete huko. Wow, angalia wale wamekaa vizuri malavi davi. Nisimchukue video mpoa wake amuone. So we went up to the rooftop of Sarit Center and oh my god, there were a lot of activities that were going on and I'm in love with this, with that place. Definitely I have to go back there with my love. And thank you so much for watching this vlog. Please take good care of your environment and love your environment. Learn new things on how to conserve your environment. See you next time. Bye bye.